Well, thank you, and good morning. I appreciate that wonderful introduction. You know, it's great to spend a couple of minutes looking back on my career. But I'll tell each and every one of you, what I am most proud of is the ability to say, I graduated from UCLA. In fact, it's my favorite question to answer. I love when people ask me, where did you graduate from? And I have the ability to say, UCLA. After today, each and every one of you get to answer that question the same way. Now, I will tell you, I have been a lifelong UCLA fan, despite the fact that I grew up in New York City before the days of ESPN. Now, for some of you, that's hard to imagine. You know, back in the day before ESPN, we only had the game of the week. That was a long time ago. But it wasn't before John Wooden and the great UCLA basketball teams. I grew up as not only a UCLA fan, but as a great fan and student of John Wooden. I feel absolutely privileged that somehow, over the course of my life, I had a chance to meet him. I had several occasions to sit in an environment like this and listen to him speak. And my favorite memory of John Wooden is actually in Poly Pavilion years ago, well after he had stopped coaching, where I would walk my son JC down to where he was sitting so he could shake hands with the coach. And I will always remember that. And John Wooden became one of my personal heroes and role models. So I know as part of the UCLA family, we will all miss him, but Coach Wooden will absolutely never, ever be forgotten. I know this is a really special day for all of you, but it's also a special day for me. And it's not just because I was asked to come here today to deliver this commencement address. Now, despite this lifelong love I've had for UCLA, I made a really unique decision 29 years ago. I handed in my last paper, I took my last final exam, I packed a bag, and I got into a taxi and went to LAX. So I woke up the next day in London, England. So why did I do that? Some great internship, a job with a multinational, a chance to study abroad? No, it was one of those old-fashioned reasons. That it was this girl I was chasing. You know? And I said, the graduation ceremony or this woman who had absolutely stolen my heart? Well, it turns out I made a really good choice because Martha Cornell is sitting with me today along with my daughter Megan and my son Jonathan. So you look back on key decisions in life, that was one of the early ones I got right. So it turns out that today, well, it's actually my commencement too. So kind of like Jack Nicholson and Morgan Freeman in the bucket list, I finally get the chance to cross this one off the list. Well, in preparation for today, I spent a lot of time talking to the UCLA team, trying to get a sense for what should I talk about? What would you be interested in? They said, you know, spend some time, Brian, talking about your own lessons learned. Things that might not show up on your bio or your resume. Well, I will tell you, it's been an interesting 29-year journey. And along the way, I've gotten a chance to cross quite a few things off that list. From UCLA to running great brands like Tropicana and Gatorade and Pepsi, roles that took me to Asia, Europe, and Latin America, I've had a chance to do things I never, ever dreamed of when I graduated from this great school 29 years ago. I've walked the streets of Delhi. I've been to Moscow, all through China. My family, well, we have more moving stickers than anyone should ever think about. But it's been a great journey. And today I get to run Sam's Club, the 9th largest retailer in the United States. So on paper, it looks like it was all part of a great master plan. But I will tell you, Like many of you, when I graduated, I really had no idea what I was going to do. As I look back on my career, well, it was really built based on a number of oddly shaped blocks that somehow, magically, all seemed to fit together. Somehow, through lots of hard work, long hours of practicing, things seemed to come together. I remember years ago when I had to give my first presentation to not thousands of people, but 10 or 20. My poor wife would be up half the night watching me rehearse. So hard work, a bit of luck, but most importantly, I know I've benefited from so many before me that took the time to share their personal wisdom with me. It really helped to assemble all those odd-shaped pieces and parts. My first real job, well, I was 10 years old. I washed trucks so I could make money to buy sports equipment and just keep up with a lot of my friends. No, my dad was not a CEO. And in fact, I never really knew him. I spent my summers as a kid washing trucks with big green Tropicana logos on them in a distribution parking lot. Somehow, 25 years later, I ran that Tropicana distribution system. And I remember when I first arrived in that professional role, the local team said, "Brian, are you sure you can relate to those drivers?" They never knew that I could relate in a way no one would have ever imagined. I worked my way through UCLA by working in retail and coaching high school football. Those early days in retail, well, it taught me a lot about the basics involved in the business. And my time coaching football, it taught me more about leadership than I ever knew. That early experience in retail, it really serves me well today. It allows me to relate to that frontline organization. And it's really shaped my overall approach to leadership. So, what are some of the key lessons I've learned in my life? First, and it's an important one for all of you, no one likes long speeches. In fact, I've never heard anyone say, "I wish he or she would have spoken longer," especially on a June morning like this. So I promise each of you, I will keep this short and to the point. But I also want to make sure you take something important away from our time together this morning. Over the years, I have learned the importance of understanding consumers, serving customers, knowing your competition, managing costs, and perhaps most importantly, how important it is to surround yourself with great colleagues, friends, and family. And also, never, ever forgetting where you came from. I call them my 5 C's for success, and I practice them throughout most of my career. I hope my lessons can help you, whether you become a lawyer, a teacher, work in government, choose a career in business, or decide to focus on becoming a great mom or dad. The first C stands for consumer focus. It's one of the key things I took away from my time at UCLA. We live in a diverse, rapidly changing world. It's a global world. This class should view themselves as global citizens. You need to stay connected with changing trends. You need to stay focused on not only the US consumer needs, but consumers around the world. What are they eating? What are they drinking? What do they read? How do they spend their time? And importantly, where do they spend their money? Follow their footsteps and stay close to the emerging consumer trends. My second C is about customers. And no matter what you do in life, you'll find yourself serving a group of customers. Learn who they are. What drives their interest and their demand? How do you lift their satisfaction? How can you build their loyalty and turn them into your advocates? If you're a teacher, you want your students to be your advocates. You want them telling other students how much they enjoy being part of your class. If you're the president of this great university, well, you want this graduating class to attract the next graduating class. If you're a lawyer, and I think if I ask for a show of hands, there might be a few that have that aspiration. Trust me, you're going to depend on your current customers, your current clients, to build future clients. The list goes on. Learn how to turn your customers into your advocates, and turn those advocates into your biggest fans. The third C is about competition. And I believe you need to take time to know as much about your competition as you do yourself. How much time do you think the team at Tropicana spends analyzing the Minute Maid business? A lot. Do you think Pepsi spends hours and hours studying everything Coke's doing around the world? You bet. At Sam's Club, do we evaluate every single product that Costco sells? Sure we do. Does Rick Neuheisel know everything about USC's offense, defense, even though they're going to spend the next couple of years on probation? Well, I hope he does. And as a country, do we need to study and understand what's happening in Japan, Germany, let alone China and India? Of course we do. So I hope you take time to study in your careers. Become a lifetime student. Evaluate and analyze your competitors. Know as much about your competitors as you do your own organization. The fourth C, well, it's about costs, and it's one that's really easy for me to talk about. I grew up learning how to count every penny. I didn't grow up in a CEO household with a CEO lifestyle. I learned early in life that for me, there were only three great equalizers: school, sports, and work. They were the only places that I could find where bank accounts weren't important, the size of your home didn't count, and no one really cared what my mom or dad did for a living. I watched my mom growing up struggling just to pay the bills. I had to find part-time jobs to pay my way through school, counted on scholarships and financial aid to pay my tuition here at UCLA. So I understand how important managing costs have been. It's been important for me since day one. But in today's economy, no matter where you go, no matter what path you choose, write it down. You're going to be challenged to manage budgets, to find productivity, to operate in what we now call the new normal. We're saving money and maximizing productivity. Well, it is a way of life. It's why I love my role at Sam's Club so much. We spend all of our time focused on saving money for our members, making savings for them, for the 47 million members we serve, really simple. It's why Sam Walton created our great company, to help people save money so they could live better. My fifth C, it's about colleagues. And it's my final lesson learned today. It's one that's been the foundation for my success, and it's really simple. At the end of the day, it's all about people. Jim Collins, who wrote the book Good to Great, talks about getting the right people on the bus. I can't tell each and every one of you how important that is. Finding the right people with the right values, with the right skills, with the right personal integrity, well, ultimately, they add up to great teams. I think it's so important that you think about that word team, that we get the pronouns right. I've found throughout my career, great things happen when I's turn to we's. And I know Coach Wooden would have agreed with that philosophy. I would also tell you to take time to build and stay in touch with your friends. It's something that I have failed to do over the course of my career. Too often, I put business and my professional focus ahead of friends and important people in my life. I would tell you, you absolutely, no matter what you do, need to make sure you find time and balance for your family. Over the years, I've been to thousands of meetings at 4, 5, 6, 7 o'clock at night that back then seemed really important. Today, no one remembers that I was there. But my son or my daughter will always remember that I missed the big game, that I missed that class production, and you will never get that time back. So find time to balance work, your career, with the importance of your family. I have really enjoyed spending this time with you today. I know it's a really special day. I hope you'll be as proud as I am the next time someone asks you, where did you graduate from? And you can say, UCLA. I hope for the rest of your lives that on Saturday afternoons in the fall, no matter where you are, no matter what you do, you'll always be wearing the blue and gold. I hope each of you has a chance to reach all of your dreams. And along the way, I hope you take time to make this a better country and make this world a better place to live in. Thank you, it's been great being with you, and congratulations to the class of 2010.